A big shakeup in Arkansas politics this week, and joining us for our first 4029 News on the Record is Attorney General Leslie Rutledge, making big news this week. And what led to the decision, Attorney General, to drop from the gubernatorial race and jump on the lieutenant governor's race?
Well, I want to, after the last 7 years serving as the Attorney General of Arkansas, had the opportunity to help people across the state. We want to continue in public service. I had overwhelming support in my gubernatorial campaign. However, I want to be able to help Sarah. She and I have been friends for a long time. I want to help my friend Sarah in her bid to be the next governor and in her administration. And that's why I launched my campaign to be the next lieutenant governor of Arkansas. I think it's important that we have people with experience and commitment to help and serve the people of Arkansas at every level. That I have done many things over the last 7 years as the attorney general, and we're going to keep doing great things. Just in the last 10 months alone, I've taken 60 plus legal actions against President Biden's overreach. We have made Arkansas the most pro-life state in the United States of America. We're going to keep pushing to make Arkansas first in educational opportunities, in tax reform, to permanently eliminate the individual income tax in the state of Arkansas. All of these things we're going to keep doing, but I'm asking the people of Arkansas to elect me as the lieutenant governor so that way we can continue to make Arkansas first together.
Attorney General, did you get any pressure from the Sanders' campaign?
No, actually. Again, Sarah and I have known each other a very long time. We have worked together. I worked for Sarah's dad when he was governor of Arkansas and when he ran for president in the United States. Sarah and I had a great conversation, and I committed to her that I am wholeheartedly going to be supporting her in her bid for governor, but also I want to support her as governor and do so in the role of lieutenant governor to, again, ensure that we're able to carry out our Christian conservative views to make sure that at this time in America's history, when our values, our constitutional rights are being attacked by those on the left, the push for socialism and communism in the United States of America, that we have had strong leaders at every level. And I believe that it's time that we unite Arkansans and that we stay united to, again, ensure that we protect our conservative values here in the natural state.
For 4029 News on the Record purposes, do you officially endorse Sarah Huckabee Sanders for governor?
Absolutely. Again, Sarah and I have been friends for a very long time. I think she brings a lot to the table. We are going to make transformational changes together as governor and lieutenant governor. And I hope nothing but the best for my friend Sarah, and I will be supporting not only her campaign for governor, but also her administration, ideally side by side as the first female governor of Arkansas and the first female lieutenant governor of Arkansas.
So how do you see that transition from a leading role into a supporting role?
Well, I think it's important that we have leaders in all roles, and I am going to be in a position as the lieutenant governor to work closely with a Governor Sanders administration to continue helping her push policies to protect our constitutional rights against overreach from the federal government, to make sure that Arkansas remains the most pro-life state in America, to increase job opportunities for our young people. That way, when they leave high school, they can go right into the workforce. In addition to having the opportunity to go to college, every child in Arkansas needs to have the opportunity to have a first-class education. Every parent in Arkansas needs to have a say-so in their child's education. That's why I've worked so hard over the last 7 years to protect Arkansans' constitutional rights. In the last 10 months alone, I've had over 60 legal actions against the Biden administration. We've kept critical race theory out of our schools in Arkansas. We have kept biological males out of all girls sports. We've done a lot of great things, and we're going to keep doing great things, but I'm hoping to do it as the next lieutenant governor of the state of Arkansas.
So you've mentioned a couple of social issues. What about the economy? Has your position on getting rid of income tax changed at all?
I think it's important that we permanently eliminate the individual income tax in the state of Arkansas, that we must not only compete, but we must beat our neighboring states of Tennessee and Texas. This will help us long-term to attract job growth, to not only continue job growth in Northwest Arkansas, but across the state of Arkansas. I would love nothing more than to see the Delta of Arkansas grow at the same exponential rate as Northwest Arkansas. We've got to ensure that not only do we have those tax credits, but that we're growing our local businesses. We want to make sure that we are giving opportunities for local home-owned businesses to expand their production lines, whether it's adding 2 more jobs or 25 more jobs. Workforce development at the junior high and high school level is important. to have kids that leave high school to be an HVAC technician, electrician, a plumber, a nurse. All of these are high-skilled jobs that we need. I've already taken actions in the last couple of weeks to protect the Arkansas workers from President Joe Biden's vaccine mandates. We sued President Biden on the federal contractor vaccine mandate. We sued President Biden on the vaccine mandate with companies with 100 or more employees, and we're suing President Biden over the healthcare worker and CMS. So we are going to protect Arkansans and Arkansas workers against these unconstitutional, illegal mandates.